The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 10th chapter, text number 1, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 6th of March, 1973, in Calcutta, India.
Sri Bhagavan Uvaca Bhuya Iva Mahabaha Sinume Paramang Vata Jatiham Priyamanaya Bhakshami Hitakamaya Bhuya. Bhuya means again, repeated. Krishna Kaksas meant it is very easy, at the same time it is very difficult. If we take it easily, just like Krishna said, sarva-dharmān parityajya māmekam śaraṇam gacchami, then it is very easy. God, Krishna, is great, and I am a fractional portion, minute portion of God. It is my duty to remain surrender unto Him. Then the matter is very easy. But we have made the matter very difficult. We are thinking in different ways, that I am God, God is dead. Why you are searching God? The God is loitering in the street, so many gods. Why you are going to temple? So many. Means, it is the business of the asuras to get away God. Conscious business. Ravana's business. Hiranyakashipu's business, demon's business, is to drive us, not transfer. Therefore, because this material world is full of demons, every one of us who is in this material world is more or less a demon. Everyone. Because, just like in the prison house, there may be some first-class prisoners, second-class prisoners, or third-class prisoners. All of them, to some extent, are criminals, violated the laws of the state. That is the position. Everyone. Similarly, anyone who is in this material world, he is to some extent a criminal. Criminal in this respect, that he has defied the authority or the supremacy of God. The degree may be different, but all of them, they have defied. That is the explanation given by one Vaishnava Kavi. Krishna bhuya jeev bhogavancha kare pasete maya tare japotiya dhare. Our, this material contact is due to our forgetfulness of Krishna. The Krishna is the only enjoyer. Krishna is the predominator. Krishna is the supreme. Krishna is the proprietor. That we have heard. Why Krishna should be only proprietor? I shall be proprietor. Why Krishna should be only enjoyer? I shall also enjoy. This mentality has put us in the material world. Krishna bhuliya jeev bhogavan chakar. Pasete mayatare japotiya dhar. This is our position. So, the maya has captured us. Why? Because we have defied the supremacy of Krishna. So all of us, more or less, Therefore, Krishna says, the tenth, Bhuya Eva Mahabhava. Arjuna is great soldier. Therefore, he is addressed as Mahabhava. Bahu, you have got Bahu. You have got Bahu. But Arjuna's Bahu is different. He can fight with thousands of men alone. How he cannot fight even with one man? Although he has got this Bahu. Therefore, he is addressed as Mahabahu. And another meaning is that unless one is very strong in determination, he cannot make any advancement in Krishna consciousness. He must be a hero. He must be able to fight with the laws of material nature. Just like in our society, there are four prohibitive principles. No illicit sex life, no intoxication, no meat eating, no gambling. So, especially at the modern age, it is very difficult to give it up. Unless man is Mahabhava, very strong, very strong. We cannot even give up drinking tea. How much strength required? So many people come, respectful gentlemen, they want me to initiate them. As soon as I say that you have to follow this principle, immediately they go. It is very difficult. Therefore, Krishna says that Bhuyeva Maha Sidume Paramahavati. Everything what Krishna says, that is Paramam, supreme, truth. Krishna cannot commit any mistake. The difference between Krishna and ourselves is that whatever we do, they are subjected to so many deficiencies because we commit mistakes. We are disillusioned and our senses are imperfect and we cheat. Krishna is not like that. Therefore, whatever he says, that is supreme, that is transcendent. He still, because we are conditional, Krishna is speaking to Arjuna in so many different ways, just to convince. This is the duty, because Krishna has been accepted by Arjuna as the spiritual master. Shishya steham sadhimam prapannam. And Krishna is teaching him. So, a teacher repeatedly says the same thing, this way, that way, negative way, positive way, so that the student may be convinced of the actual truth. Therefore he says, Bhuyo, again I am saying to you. Actually, the Bhagavad Gita means to surrender to Krishna. Two words. Surrender to Krishna, but will not surrender. Therefore, Krishna has to speak to Arjuna in so many ways. Otherwise, he immediately accepts to surrender to Krishna. That is perfect knowledge. Arabhita jadi harish tapasa tatak kim. If one is engaged in worshipping, in rendering devotional service to Krishna, when all his tapas are finished, he has got the result of all tapas. Arādhita jadi harīs tapasā tatah kīm nava tapasya. If you have developed your love for Krishna, and in loving attitude you are engaged in his transcendental service, then your all tapas are finished. You have got the result. Result of all tapas. Because human life is meant for tapasya, tapodibbam. It is not to waste our time like cats and dogs. Cats and dogs eating, sleeping, sexual intercourse and defending. This is business of cats and dogs and hogs. The human business is tapasya, That is Vedic civilization. Tapo Dibbang. Dibbang Tapasya. Not like Hiranyakashipu. Hiranyakashipu also underwent very severe penances and austerity. But what was his aim? His aim was that I shall be very, very powerful and I shall live forever and I shall go on acting like a demon without any check. That was his purpose. Everyone is doing like that. I shall acquire so much money, bank balance, and my business should be so big, and I shall be minister, I shall be president, so that everyone will open his La Puja Pratishtha. Profit and adoration and fame. These three things everyone wants. So, but we have to submit. We are so much papta that we cannot submit. Therefore Krishna has to say repeatedly, Arjuna, his instructor, his student, his student, Krishna is Guru, it is the business of Guru to instruct. Bhuyaiva Mahabhava Sinume Paramangvata Jatteham Priyamanaya Bhakshami Hitakamaya. Priyamana, you are my dear friend. Unless one is very dear, so to become dear to the teacher, therefore our system is sam tadviddhi pranipatena pariprasnena sevaya. You have to very humbly submit to the spiritual master, give him service, satisfy him. Then Priyakama, he thinks that here is a student who is very submissive, very humble. He requires to be taught very nicely. That Krishna said, Jatiham Priyamana Bhakshami Hidokam. Well is teacher must be well wishing. At the present moment, teachers are disrespected. How he can be well wishing? The other day I went to the university for lecture. One of the teachers said that I was bombed in this room. Few months ago, I was bombed in this room. The student threw bomb. This is going on. So how the teachers will be well-wisher of the student? It is the injunction of the Shastra that the physician, the teachers, they should be very much respected. According to Vedic system, if a physician comes to a patient, the patient should accept the physician as father. So, he may be compassionate, he can administer the best medicine. Similarly, the teacher should be respected so that he may be compassionate. Hitakama, he will give the best instruction. So Krishna, Arjuna has already proved that he is a very submissive, Sishasyam Sadimam Prapanna. Already he has surrendered, Prapanna. Therefore, Krishna says, Hitakamaya for your wealth. So, he again says, Name vidushuragana prabhavam nam maharsaya aham adirhi devanam maharsinam cha sarvas. The first thing is, what is Krishna? He has repeatedly said, again he said, the devana. One may think that Krishna is born some 5,000 years ago. They will question that before Krishna was born, there was no Krishna worship. Because they do not know what is Krishna. Krishna is worshipped long from the beginning of the creation. That's why Brahma. Brahma is the beginning of creation. So he also worships. Jang Brahma Varunanda Rudra Maruta Sunanti Vibhaistavai. Jang Brahma. Brahma worships him. Varunanda Indra. All the demigods worship him. So Krishna is Adi. That's the fact. Therefore Krishna says, Aham Adihi Devanam because Brahma is the first Deva, then Lord Shiva, then other all Devas. Vishnu, of course, before Brahma. Vishnu is in the material world. Vishnu is also considered as one of the Devas. Maha, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesha, Adi Deva. The Vishnu is also called by Krishna. That I have explained several times. Krishna is the origin of Vishnu. From Krishna, first expanded, Ekam Bhushyama, Krishna has expanded in many fold, Vishnu Tattva, Jiva Tattva. We are also Krishna's expansion. And the Vishnu Tattva is also Krishna's expansion. And the demigods, they are also Krishna's expansion. Everyone, Ekam Bhushyama, he has become one. The Supreme One has expanded himself in so many ways. Vishnu Tattva, Jiva Tattva, Shakti Tattva. Therefore, Krishna is the origin of everything. Aham Aditi Devanam, because we take the first, the Devas, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesha. So Krishna's first expansion is Swayam Prakash, Baladev Tattva. Swayam Prakash. From Baladev Tattva, the quadruple tattvas, namely Shankar, Vasudev, Shankar, San, Pradyumna, Nirupa. Then again, from Sankarsa, there is Narayana. Then again, from Narayana's second quadruple expansion, again Shankar, San, Pradyumna, Anirudha. And from Sankarsa, these three Vishnus. Three Vishnus means Karuna Navasai Vishnu, then Gadbhodak Sai Vishnu, Hirodak Sai Vishnu. Then from Hirodak Sai Vishnu, from Gadbhodak Sai Vishnu is Brahma, and Vishnu also, Hirodak Sai Vishnu, and from Brahma is Lord Shiva. In this way, other devatas, Indra, Chandra, Varuna, Sun, Moon, so many, there are millions of. Devi gods, millions of human beings, millions of lower than Deva Tijjang Naradishu. Deva means demigod. Tijjang means lower than human beings, animals, birds, beasts, trees, and the human being, Naradishu. So the expansion is very much. But the origin of all expansion is Krishna. That is the reality. Aham adihi devana. Name vidu suragana. Suragana means the devata. Name vidu suragana. Prabhamana maharsaya. And great sages, Marichyadi. There are same great sages. Marichi, Vasishta, Atreya. The same stars you see on the northern pole. They are the planets of these great seven rishis. So they are there. So even these great sages, they also do not know what is the actual position of Krishna. Krishna himself does not know what is his actual position. Krishna is so great. Krishna, to understand himself, he came as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, devotee of Krishna, to understand. Because Krishna wanted to know himself, so he could know himself in the attitude of Radharani. So he took the attitude of Radharani. Therefore Radharani and Krishna when combined together, that is not Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Radha Krishna nahe anna Sri Krishna Chaitanya. Sri Krishna Chaitanya, these Goswamis, they have studied that Radha Krishna Pranaya Vikiti Alladini Shakti Rasmat Vikatmanavati Dehu Vedu Vadoto. Krishna is one, but when Krishna wants to enjoy, he must expand his pleasure potency. That is Radha. Radha Krishna, Pranay Vidhi. Krishna cannot enjoy anything material. So the original spiritual potency, pleasure potency is Radha. So, first of all he expanded. Then again he combined together. That is Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This is the study of the Bhushan. Radha Krishna Pranaya Vikiti Alladini. Therefore Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is given seat along with Krishna. His combination of Radha and Krishna. We may not misunderstand that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is imitating Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. There are so many so-called avatars. But this is approved by the Shastra. Krishna Varnam, Tisha Krishnam, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna. Same category, Krishna Varnam. Just like we say Varna, Brahman Varna, Kshatriya Varna, Shudra Varna, Vaishya Varna. Varna means the same category. Varna. Or Krishna Varnam means who is always describing Krishna. Just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is passing on the road. He's chanting, Krishna, 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 He. Krishna, 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 He. Krishna, 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 Pahimam. Therefore, Krishnam Varnayati, iti Krishna. If Krishna is describing himself, Krishna Varnam, Tisha Krishna, but by his complexion, he's not black. Very clear complexion. Krishna Varnam Tisha Krishnam Sangma Panga Sapasam. But he is always accompanied by his associates. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Srivara Sadhi Gaurva. So this Krishna, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is also Krishna. But people misunderstand, because to understand Krishna, it requires knowledge. From Krishna or from Krishna's representative. Krishna is not knowable. Munisanam sahase, kaschid jatati siddha, jatatava visidhyanam kaschid betrimam tattata. Out of many millions of persons, one may be liberated. Jatatava pi siddha. Siddha means liberated. Siddhi means to know oneself. At the present moment, we are conditioned, we are thinking that I am this body. Jasyatma buddhi kunava. God is to think of this body as self, is the business of the cats and dogs. Saiva gokhara. Gokhara means animals. Go means cows and khara means ass. So, every one of us, practically, we are identifying with this body. Therefore, we are not siddha. Siddha means one who is completely free from the bodily concept of love. Brahma bhuta, prasannatma, nasochati, nakam, samasarveshu bhutesh. Unless one is fully convinced that I am not this body. And similarly, if I am not convinced that these people, they are also not body. They are all spirit soul. Therefore, one who is actually Pandit, in the real understanding of things, Pandita Samadarsino, he sees everyone, part and parcel of Krishna. That is Samadarsino. Samasarveshu bhuteshu madhvakti lavati para. Then bhakti begins. Bhakti is not a sentiment. Bhakti is the first stage of understanding, knowledge. That is bhakti. Bhakta sruta grihitaya. Bhagavad says, bhakta sruta bhakti must be executed sruta grihitaya by hearing sruta. By hearing from disciples succession. That is perfect bhakti. And in that bhakti, bhakta amam avijana. Are on the transcendental platform of bhakti, then you can understand what is Krishna. Therefore Krishna says that Name Vidu Suradhana. But Suradhana, the big demigods, they are also not in the pure stage of bhakti. They have got bhakti. Bhakti Mishra. Mixed bhakti. They have got desire to enjoy this material world. They are called devotees. Just like Brahma, what is Pitapada? He has got a desire to lord it over the material world. So he has been given. But he is a bhakta, but not pure bhakta. Pure bhakta means anna vilasita sunnam. No material. Just like Bhaktivinoda Thakur said, Brahma janame nahi mora asa. I do not desire even to take birth as Lord Brahma. Because that is not pure bhakti. Brahma is bhakta undoubtedly. Unless he is a very high class bhakta, how he can be offered such exalted post? Just like in government service, unless one is not very confidential, he cannot be given any confidential post. Similarly, all these devotas, they are devotees undoubtedly. But karma mishra, jnana mishra, they are not pure devotees. Pure devotee, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu teaches us, na dhanang na janang na sundaring kavitang bhajagadi sakavai. This is pure devotee. Na dhanang na janang na sundaring kavitang bhajagadi sakavai. I don't want for this. I don't want money. I don't want big followers. I don't want very beautiful wife. Sundaring kavitang bhajagadi sakavai. Then what do you want? Mama janmani janmani sari bhavatad bhakti rahui kiti kai. Ohi tu. Without any reason. Without any desire. I want to serve you. So unless we cannot come to that position, pure devotional life, we cannot understand Krishna. It is not possible. Therefore Krishna says, nami vidu suragana. Prabhamangana. Because they do not know. Therefore they think Krishna, just like Brahma, was bewildered. When Lord Krishna was playing as a cowherd boy, everywhere it is advertised that Krishna has come in this world and now he is in Vrindavan playing as a cowherd boy. So Brahma became doubtful, Krishna is my Lord, I worship and he has become a cowherd boy. Let me test. It is really God, really Krishna. So he took away all his coward boys, calf and everything. By his, he is very powerful. But Krishna immediately expanded himself in so many cows and coward boys and calves. Then he understood that, yes, here is Krishna. So, muihanti yatra suraya, the Bhagavad says, that great demigods, suraya, they become bewildered to understand Krishna. They become bewildered. Therefore, it is not very easy to understand Krishna. But if we can acquire somehow or other a little mercy of Krishna, then we can understand. This is the process. Adasya Krishna Namadina Bhavi Gayan Indriya Vayya. Gymnastic process of this indriya, senses, mental speculation, you cannot understand Krishna. That is not possible. Athapi te deva padambhujadvayam prasada lesanu grihita yuk janati tattam. The thing is, Krishna should be understood in tattva. So, to understand Krishna in tattva, you have to become submissive, render service to Krishna, under the direction of Krishna, then bhaktyamama vijanati javan jachan tattva. Then you can understand Krishna. Otherwise it is not possible to understand Krishna. And those who are murhas, means those who are thinking of Krishna as ordinary boy, ordinary human, cowherd's boy, abhijananti, mang murha. Krishna is just like Krishna's attack by so many atheists. that he is taken as ordinary human being. No, Krishna is not human. Therefore Krishna says, Nami vidu suragana. Nami vidu suragana prabhavam. Krishna's prabha, his influence also not known. He is so influential. He can do anything, whatever he likes. That is Krishna. Prabhavam na maharshaya. Aham adihi devanang maharshinang cha sarvas. Sarvas. I am the origin of everyone. This you should understand. How he becomes origin of everything. If you accept Krishna's statement, that is sufficient, that Krishna is the origin of everything. If you do not accept, you cannot make analytical study how Krishna is origin. The Shastra will give you evidence. Yes, Krishna is the origin of everything. This is Krishna consciousness. One must be fixed up in his understanding of Krishna, that he is the origin of everything. He is the origin of everything. Aham adihi devanam maharshinam cha sarvasam. Then Krishna says, Jumang ajam anadim cha vekti loko maheswaram asangamura samarteshu sarva papai pramasyate. Anyone who is fully convinced, Jumang ajam. Ajam means unborn. If one takes Krishna, that Krishna is born historically, 5,000 years ago, and as the son of Vasudev and Devaki, and he accepted, Vasudev Devaki could not raise him. He was dispatched to Yashoda. This is also good. But he does not take birth, because people contest that how God can take birth. He does not take birth. That is misunderstanding. Therefore one should know how Krishna takes his birth. Therefore in the fourth chapter it is clearly said, if anyone understands this simple fact, how Krishna takes his birth, this one item, how Krishna is ajam. How takes his birth? Janma karma me dibba. Jo janati tattva. Simply this one thing, if one can understand how Krishna takes his birth and why does he come to work with us, just like Krishna came and worked with Arjuna, and he took part in the battlefield as charioteer of Arjuna. Only these things, if we can understand, then we become liberated. Janma karma me dibbam ju janati tattva. If we understand these two things in fact, then what happens? Sakta deham punar janma naiti mame iti told. Then he becomes liberated. Liberation begins as soon as you begin devotional service. Immediately. Because Krishna says, Sarvadharman paritajya mamekam saranam aham tva sarva papi bhamakhasam. Immediately you are liberated. Bondage means so long the reaction of karma is there. But he says, he assures, the aham tva sarva papi bhamakhasam. I shall give you liberation from all sinful reaction of life. We are entangled for sinful reaction of life. If you are actually pious, then there is no more. But actually pious means to become a devotee. Unless one is a pure devotee, he is not pious. Comparatively, he may be pious, because there are degrees of pious. Therefore, Krishna says, Jesam antagatam papam. One who is completely free from all impious activities. Papam. Because here sometimes we think that we are making so many sacrifices. This is punna, punna karma. But there is papas. Because in the sacrifices there are sometimes animal sacrifices. So there is papa. For one kind of punna, we commit another kind of papa. Or in ordinary way, sometimes a big man accumulates some money and spends for charitable purpose, for opening schools, hospitals, but he has earned the money from black market. So this is the world. If you want to do something pious activities in this material world, you have to do something impious activities also. That is papa. So therefore, unless you transcend all this business of papa and punna, you cannot be free from this material bondage. Jagannathanda Thakur says, karmakanda gyanakanda sakali bishera bhanda. Karmakanda means pious activities. Or gyanakanda means culturing knowledge. This is called gyanakanda. So karmakanda gyanakanda sakali bishera bhanda. Jagannathanda Thakur, in a very simple Bengali language, bishera bhanda, a pot of poison. Amrita bolya jiva khar. If you take a pot of poison as nectarine, then what is it? Nana jani brahman kare kadajya bhakkhan kare tar janma adhokpate jana. So we should not take karma kanda kana kanda. We have created our activities on these two fields, karma kanda and kana kanda. Karma means karmis. Those who are trying to enjoy this material world by activities, different types of activities, they are karmakanda, in rough estimate. And another gyanakanda, the gyani, they say when they are frustrated in doing, they say this is all false. Brahma sattva jagan mitha. So this is gyanakanda. But bhakti is above karmakanda, gyanakanda. Annavilasita sunnam jnana karmad anabritam. In this material world, karmakandi or ganakanda is going on. The karmis are thinking that very clever, they are enjoying life. They will enjoy life in this world, again they will be elevated to the heavenly planet, there they will enjoy, there they enjoy. So, according to their estimation, they are very intelligent. And the jnanis, they are thinking that we have worked as karmis, but we never derived any benefit out of it. Therefore, this is all false. The grapes are sour, jivita, jako. Now let us become sannyasi and become Brahma. Become one with God. We have let this, paltry enjoyment. Let me become the Supreme Narayan. Introduce themselves as Narayan. Narayan means the enjoyer of Lakshmi, Lakshmi Narayan. So, at the heart, they have got the desire to capture Lakshmi, the original Lakshmi. And outwardly, they are sannyasi. They have given up everything, mithya. But at heart, there is the desire to enjoy Lakshmi. So, therefore, phalgu vairag. But the devotee is above this karma kanda, jnana kanda, jnana karma dhanabhritam, anukillena krishna anusilanam. They are ready to serve the order of Krishna. Never mind what it is. It may be jnana kanda, karma kanda or anything, but that is not the fact. If you are ready to serve Krishna in all conditions, just like Arjuna did, yes, karishe vachanam tam. Yes, I shall work what you are instructing me. Nasto moho. Now my all illusion is gone. I was thinking on the platform of karma kanda and jnana kanda. Now my illusion is gone. Tatprasada masu madhusuda. By your grace, I am now above. I am now prepared. You want me to fight? Yes, I shall kill all the other side. Never mind, they are my grandfather, brothers. This is bhaktika. Karma kanda, jnana kanda, if we remain in karma kanda, jnana kanda, then he cannot come to the bhakti kanda. Bhakti kanda is above. When Krishna says sarva dharman parityajya, that means We have manufactured so many religious systems on the basis of Parvakanda and Gyanaka. So we have to give up all this. Then we come to the Bhakti Kanda, Bhaktyamam Abhijanati. When you understand Krishna on the platform of Bhakti, then our life is successful. Evam prasanna manasu bhagavata bhakti yogata. Mukta sangasya jayate. Bhagavat tattva vijnanam mukta sangasya jayate. Evam prasanna manasu bhagavata bhakti yogata. When by executing devotional service, when you become sublimely jubilant, prasanna manasu, because in Bhakti Kanda, when you are engaged in the service of the Lord, we become jubilant. Because that is our real life. Mukti means to come to the real position. Our real position is Jiva Sarupa Nitya Krishna Das. So when you come to that position, to become Krishna's Das, that is our real constitutional position, naturally we become jubilant. So Karma Kanda, Jnana Kanda, Sakali Visarabhan, Anna Vilasita Sundam, Jnana Karma Adana Vritam, Anukul Vena Krishna Anusilanam, Bhakti Uttama. This is Bhakti. So the Krishna consciousness movement means to place everyone on the platform of Bhakti. And it is very easy in these days. Every time it is very easy, but people are not very much inclined to accept easy things. Sahaja. Sahaja means with my butt, but it's born. Sahaja. Ja means take butt. So sahaja, as we are living entities, our birthright is to serve Krishna. That is sahaja. Therefore Krishna says, Sarvadharmān Paritrishmā, you are meant for this purpose. Therefore in every human being, there is bhakti, nitya siddha krishna bhakti. There is sahaja, spontaneously born bhakti. Just like a child is obedient to the parents, this is sahaja. So we give up the sahaja, we take the difficulty. I become Lord, I am God, there is no God. We take all this nonsense. Giving up the sahaja. Therefore, if we become strong, if we take up the simple thing that God is great, we are small particle, part and parcel of God. Our business is to serve God. Then it is sahaja. It is very simple. Otherwise, it is very difficult. So, Krishna is teaching Bhagavad Gita how to become situated in your original position, to understand yourself, that you are eternal servant of God, then your life is successful. Thank you very much.